Welcome to our science session of 5th class. Now we are going to go into 5th lesson. Let us plant trees. Plants and trees. Do you know what it was? How can we can call the plants? That when we sowing the seed in the soil, the baby plant will coming outside. That is called plant. That after that few days, few months after going on, the plants become a big plant. That big plant is called trees. You know how can we identify the trees? Yes, we can identify the trees because that tree have woody stem, strong woody stem, and so many branches. That is we can call them big plants are called trees. That we have to go into learn about the plants and the different types of trees. And trees have different type of branches and different types of trees are giving fruits, and they give some furniture. We have to using the wood of trees furnitures our daily life. See, no, have you know, look at the textbook here. I am showing to you. Look at the textbook. See, first page is there. Look at the image of a forest shown here. This is the image of forest. Have you ever visited a forest? Are you visited a forest? Name any two animals and plants that you have saw. And you know, in the forest we can identify the animals like lion, tiger, and plants like medicinal plant tulsi. Something we can identify that plants and trees. And we have to visited any trees, any forest nearby you, and think, and you can identify the forest, how it is there, thick forest or small forest. Identify yourself. This is that we have to go into next page in this our textbook. You can see, I will show the picture again. This is about that fish. This is called forest. Why? Because it is totally greenery, so many plants, different types of plants we have to see in that textbook. See here, forests are large, thickly populated areas with the different kinds of animals and plants. Yes, we have to see the picture. Here we view of the picture is that we have to see the thickly forest. So many different types of plants and animals, and the trees are there. We have to see that in the picture. And that many various trees, shrubs, herbs are found here. They are home to a wide variety of animals and birds. Yes, we have to know that in that forest, so many different types of animals, wild animals, like some animals are live in some caves, and some animals are living on the trees, some animals are living sheds, some animals are living, they have to arrange the some different type of homes. And as well as in the forest, the birds also living. Birds are build their nest in the trees, on the trees, and they have to lay eggs on the trees, and they can protect the baby birds. And the different types of birds we have to see. In that, they give us very useful products and helping in the regulating climate conditions. Yes, regulated climate condition means, what is the weather we have to go into summer seasons? What is the seasons? We have to have three types of seasons: summer season, winter season, rainy season. That is that we regulated the weather. Which one? The forest are regulated the weather conditions. They have to come in the such type of time. Then in rainy season, rain will comes in summer season. Heavy hot is there. Sun is bright in that summer season. That is that regulated in the climate conditions, which help us, the forest help us to us. The forest covered about the one by third. Yes, forest cover about one third of the land on the earth. And that, but ever the last few decades, humans have been exploiting the forest cover at faster rate. We have been cutting down trees to buildings, our homes and shopping malls of offices to create farmland, make paper, furniture, etc. Yes, we have to cut in the forest because of our daily uses. Because of that, what is the we are using? We have to cut in the trees for that house. We have to make house and household things like tables, chairs, furniture, sofa sets. We have to using and offices. We have to using the office things we need of wood. That's why the forest is going to decreasing. And that as much of land that once covered with the forest no longer has trees. There are so many few years we have to cutting down the trees. Then we have to not planting another new plants. Because of that's why the trees are going to disappear. Then we have to, when that we have to cut the one tree, we have to planting three trees. That is the sustainment and the balance in the nature. Then is that as a result of the area occupied by the forest decreasing. Yes, every few years ago we have to cutting the trees, the area is go, forest area is decreasing means tagipothundi forest in the area. Enduku manam trees ni cut chestunnam kabatti. This affects the climate and the wildlife. Ee vidhanga cheyadam valla emaindi effect em avutundi wildlife ante adavilo unde lion, tiger, monkeys, bears. ఇవన్నీ ఏం చేస్తున్నాయి అడవిలో ప్లేస్ తగ్గిపోయిన తర్వాత ఏమొస్తున్నాయి మనం ఉండే సరౌండింగ్స్ వస్తున్నాయి దే హార్మ్ఫుల్ టు అస్ దే హ్యావ్ టు కమింగ్ దట్ సరౌండింగ్స్ ఆఫ్ అవర్ హోమ్స్ ఎస్ ఆర్ నో వీ హ్యావ్ టు ఎవ్రీ డే వీ హ్యావ్ టు సీ ద న్యూస్ దట్ వైల్డ్ యానిమల్స్ ఆర్ కమింగ్ టు సరౌండింగ్ దోస్ లివింగ్ ఏరియాస్ ఏం చేస్తున్నాయి ప్లేసెస్ తగ్గిపోయేసరికి ఏమొస్తున్నాయి అవన్నీ మన ఇంటి చుట్టూ వస్తున్నాయి మనకు హార్మ్ఫుల్ మనకు హార్మ్ చేస్తున్నాయి అందుకే వీ హ్యావ్ టు ప్లాంటింగ్ మోర్ ట్రీస్ వీ హ్యావ్ టు గ్రో మోర్ ట్రీస్ వీ హ్యావ్ టు ప్లాంటింగ్ ప్లాంట్స్ దెన్ వి మెనీ స్పైసెస్ ఆఫ్ ఎనిమల్స్ ఆర్ బీయింగ్ పనిష్డ్ టు ఎక్స్టెన్షన్ డ్యూ టు ద లాస్ ఆఫ్ దేర్ హ్యాబిటేషన్స్ ఎస్ they are not sustained in the living areas because of they have to their own areas they are living in the forest in this busy surroundings we have to not using that this type of weather then that we should realize that many harm that we cause to the environment will have a direct effect on us yes this effect they are coming to our living surrounding areas this effect fall on us because of we have to disturbing the wild animals to our surrounding areas then we have to provide the areas they have to live in that then we have to planting trees and increasing the trees level that we should protect the forest and plant more trees so let us learn about how to grow plants and the necessary conditions required to for planting trees how it is the plantings we have to learn about that this lesson because of that growing plants and we have to grow the plants in the necessary that is useful to the wildlife protect the wildlife and decrease more trees now we have to learn about the plants not only prepare their own food but also they are producers of food for all living things they are producer because of they are giving vegetables and fruits then we can call them producers yes plants make their own food by process called photosynthesis plants make their own food by a process called photosynthesis they use carbon dioxide from the air water from the soil and sunlight to prepare their food see observe the pictures you can identify the picture see is a sunlight taking their plant and carbon dioxide taking inside the plants are giving to outside of oxygen they can absorb the water from the soil from the roots they can send to all parts of the body. Yes, they use carbon dioxide from the air and water from soil and sunlight to prepare their food. This takes place in green leaves in the presence of the oxygen substance called chlorophyll. Yes, in see children, you can observe the plant, the leaves are in green. The most plants have green in color leaves. Then the presence of sunlight, they can substance of green is called chlorophyll. Yes, that is green in color. They have to doing make their food in presence of sunlight, that is called chlorophyll. Oxygen is released during the process, during this process, which is that photosynthesis going on, that chlorophyll, they have to make their own food, and that time the oxygen will released outside of the plant. They have to taken inside the carbon dioxide. Next we have to go to that, we have to go to the lesson. See, look at the board. See, we can observe the plant. The plant's taking the sunlight, and they can observe the from the roots of the plants. They can observe the soil, water, and they can send to the water minerals to all parts of your plant. And they can take the carbon dioxide. They release it to the oxygen outside. Then the plants, in presence of sunlight, the plant make their own food. This is called photosynthesis. The green in color of their leaves, that is called chlorophyll. That this process going on, when photosynthesis going on the process, this action oxygen giving outside in the chlorophyll, they have to make their food, and they have to plants gradually grow more, grow by day. That green in substance is called chlorophyll. Next we have to learn about that light. The plants need sunlight to make their food. Yes, without sunlight the plants do not make their food. In the presence of sunlight the plants make their food. Next we have to go water. Without water, why? Because the roots of the parts of the plant's roots, from the water we have to give into the plant. From the roots, observe the roots, and they can send the all parts of body. Parts means branch, leaves, stem, fruits, flowers. These are called parts of your plants. The roots to plant to send to the water and minerals to all parts of the body. Which one? The water. Water helps to transport nutrients from soil to different parts of your plants. Yes, when we pour in the water to plant, the roots are absorbing in the soil minerals and vitamins, and that they can send it to the plant to all parts of the body. This is about the water. Next we have to go into that, learn about that fertile soil. Because without soil, without seed we will not grow the baby plant. Fertile soil provides a plant with all the essential nutrients required for its growth. Yes, when the soil is fertile, the plants will grow healthy. That is, fertile means grow good. Next, carbon dioxide. This is that plants take carbon dioxide present in air to make their food. Yes, in the present air, the plants take in the carbon dioxide and giving out the oxygen, and they have to make their food. This is about the parts of a plant. Next session we have to go into that about the trees. What is the importance of trees? Most important notice, Nana. Children, listen carefully. In the last week we have to conduct the AP1 exams, and some members are attended the exams, and it's a WhatsApp group. They have to send it and they have to submit answer sheets in our school. But so many children are not write the exam. Because of you must listen, Nana. Those who are complete the FA1 exams, those who are giving to answer sheets in the school, that members promoted next class. Suppose example, you are in 4th class last year. Now you are in 5th class. If you write the FA1 exam, you can promote it as well as going to attendance in the 5th class. Those who are not giving in school question paper and answer sheets, that members not giving to answer sheets in school, that members not getting on attendance and not going to 5th class.
They are in fourth class only. Those are giving FA1 answer sheets in the school. That members only promoted fifth class. Okay, Nana. Thank you. Buy the books compulsory. Without books, you can't understand science, social, English, and math.